see them again later. Welcome to Argenta's Drag Race, Season 3, Episode 1. So we have this kind of March Madness thing going on. It's gonna be neat. We make drag queens do sports. Great. Oh, yes. Our sponsors this evening include Arda Wigs and Absolute Vodka. Because in an absolute world, everybody would be a winner. Just not here. So let's meet our judges. Our first judge is T. English, one of the members of the hit Prince cover band Royalty. Drag enthusiast. All around badass bitch. Yes. My darling, my hamburger, how are you this evening? I'll turn on your mic, girl.
I am awesome. I'm so excited to be here.
Well, we're excited to have you.
Yes.
Are you ready for it to get a little shady?
I'm so ready for it to get shady. I got my sunglasses, my umbrella,
bitch.
Sunscreen, everything. I'm ready.
All right. Our second judge over here is Mocha TWT, the dancing diva of Bloomington. Girl, call the police, because bitch, you are mugged. Yes. So, tonight's episode, they have one mini challenge. They were all given ref shirts that look like this, and they have to use them creatively. We'll see what happens. Their second runway challenge, they were given a Big Ten school. So, you know, University of Michigan, Iowa, IU, all of those schools. And they have to interpret that on the runway. Let's see what happens with that. And then their last one is Pop Divas. They're doing a Pop Diva number. It's just a straight up number where it's playing the radio, no edits, no anything like that. So, are you guys ready? Our judges, are you ready? Yeah? I don't know if I'm ready. Hold on. I need a cocktail. Oh, let me get on the side of the table. All right. Are you ready back there, ladies? Woo! All right, ladies. First out to the stage is Kara Von Lord from Terre Haute, Indiana. Your next contestant onto the stage tonight, all the way from Bloomington, Indiana, Miss Billy V.
Hi, my name's Billy V. I'm 24 years old and I'm from Bloomington, Indiana. Miss Argenta, I really hope I pass my test.
So do we. All right, ladies and gentlemen, contestant number 3, Stephanie Cummings.
Welcome to the back door. My name is Tiffany Cummins, and I'm actually contestant number 1 and only.
Y'all, I'm gonna put a GoPro in the dressing room next week. They've been shady as hell back there. Oh, all right, contestant. Which number are we on? 4. Contestant number 4, Keisha Von Lord.
And you're just distinguished panel of judges, for your consideration tonight, ladies and gentlemen. I am contestant number four, and just like Burger King, I plan to serve up Big Fish.
Come on, Big Fish. Or can we have it our way, too? All right, ladies and gentlemen, contestant number five, Emma Octavia Winters.
Octavia Winters. I'm 23 years old, and all these other bitches, I'm calling foul.
Oh. All right, ladies and gentlemen, and your final contestant, contestant number six, Miss Oliver New.
Hey there, Bloomington. My name is Oliver New. I am 24 years old, and if you can't figure out the name, either take a fucking look or take a fucking French class. Thank you.
Thank God I took Spanish. Bring onto the stage your first contestant, Miss Kiara Von Lord. Ladies and gentlemen, representing the University of Michigan, the Maize and Blue, the Wolverines, the one and only Billy V.
The 235 member Michigan Marching Band. Band. Under the direction of Professor Jamie L. Nix, the M Fanfare.
Ladies and gentlemen, Billy B. Next, representing Penn State, the one and only Stephanie Cummings. Ladies and gentlemen, representing Northwestern University, Miss Keisha Von Lord. Octavia Winters, representing the University of Minnesota. Your last contestant, representing Michigan State, the one and only Oliver New.
Woo!
So we're in the round where they're going to do Pop Divas. They were not allowed to modify the song in any way. They had to do the song directly how it was played on the radio. All right, ladies and gentlemen, let's bring onto the stage your first contestant, Miss Kiara Von Lord.
I'm
your third contestant, Tiffany Cummings.
Oh,
Apparently it's a Janet Jackson Super Bowl night. All right, ladies and gentlemen, let's give it up for your final contestant of the evening, the one and only Oliver New.
Competition.
You are not from Chicago, bitch. You can't be doing that.
Who
Jesus. It was explained how we do this earlier. Let me just put that out there for y'all. Some folks apparently can't follow rules.
What? Why? Oh, I'm surprised. She's the lightest one up there.
Yeah. All right, ladies, we are going to give you some critiques. These are live. Also, ladies and gentlemen of the audience, none of these critiques are supposed to be mean. You have to understand that between the three of us up here, we have, what, like 30 years of experience in the drag and entertainment world. I just celebrated 11 years myself.
Yes!
This fuck, bitch. Did you not know?
See, bitch, can't you look at her face?
And that's real, bitch. You see these wrinkles. Don't fuck with me.
Bitch, that's why they Botox.
Okay, right. Okay. Yes.
Don't fuck like her hair. Her head is big enough. Stop it. Bitch, this is not hair. This is not wig. This is her head.
This is my natural hair. What?
Hey, quiet down.
Oh, I'm not trying to run for president, bitch. Y'all wouldn't want that. Bitch, no, I would. You couldn't imagine. I would fit the Capitol with an updo. Anyway, all right, we're going to do some critiques. So, T, I'm going to start with you. You're nice.
All right, so Matilda wrote. No, I'm just kidding. Wrong.
Yes, bitch. Matilda.
Okay, so I want you ladies to know that I applaud. So I am a drag enthusiast, and I love everything about drag. So know that I'm speaking to you as a consumer. So, Kiara. Oh, bitch, you're exotic. I got it. All right, Kiara. I'm just going to give you a few quick notes. I want you to commit more. Like, I feel like you're giving me seduction sexy, but you're just kind of giving me sexy. Like, you're giving me 80% sexy and 20% like, ugh, I don't know, I have to fart. Like, so just give it all to me. So that's mine.
I can't with you.
Bitch, you gotta know what your ministry is. Billy, I want you to know that I wrote on my sheet, share, ?! I just want you to know, you're making really smart choices. Please keep making those choices. Please keep doing that. You're making very smart choices, so keep doing that. I also wrote on my sheet, come through, bitch. Give me some more, queen. You're another one that I feel like is giving me 80. You got 20% in the tank. Give it to me. You're making smart choices. Make them pay off, okay? Stephanie, hi, how are you, sweetie? I wrote that I loved your little cute pop diva outfit, and I loved your pop diva thing. Everything that you gave me in that, I need you to give me that every time I see you. Because when you came for your pop diva, I was like, have I seen her before? So make sure that you're giving me all of that. The other thing I wrote, and I'm going to speak to you as a person, you've got really small eyes. I have very tiny eyes too. And I felt like in your pop diva, you were selling me in your face, but there was so much going on with your eyes. Like, they say that is your window to your soul for a reason. So make sure that you're giving me some eye stuff and figure out what you need to do so that I can see your eyes, because you were selling, but I couldn't buy it because I couldn't see it. Okay?
She was Keisha, selling, you ain't buying.
Hey boo, I run on yours. Come on, yitties. Them titties, girl. But if you gonna give them to me, give them to me. And if you wanna put them away, put them away. And I'm talking to you as a double D diva. I know what it is, bitch. Sometimes you need to go to JCPenney's and get a bra fitting. Like, I'm serious. So, like, if you want them, and in that number, I can tell you didn't want them out. And that took away from your performance. So if you want them out, let them fly. Because titties are beautiful, okay? But if you want to put them away, put them motherfuckers away.
Won't he?
Tell him.
Victoria's Secret, bitch.
Emma, how are you, lovely?
Beautiful, how are you?
You are beautiful. Make me want to see more of you, please. Because you are beautiful, and you've got something to sell. You're another one that I said, titties. Yeah, I know. Yeah. Hey, see him, let me see him. Yeah, there we go. Oliver, how are you, sweetheart? Don't do that. Don't do that. This is what I'm gonna say to you. You have a different voice.
No.
No, you don't? What you gave me was different and I loved it. But you gotta commit to it and you have to make me want it. Because you're different, you're gonna have to justify it. And you can, but you have to, okay? So I want you to realize that you've got a beautiful voice and you've got something to say and there are people who want it, but you have to do it. Does that make sense, love? Because I love everything about you. Everything about you, I love it, but you have to make me want it, okay? You can't be like, oh, that was it. You have to be like, I don't know what the fuck I loved about that, but I want more of it, right? It's like cheesecake. You don't know why the fuck you love that shit, but you just have to keep eating it. And before you know it, the whole thing is gone and you didn't share with nobody. Like, that's what you are, okay?
Can I have cheesecake now?
So do that, okay? Okay? I want you to do that. I'm going to beat you up if you don't do that, and that's not a threat.
Oh.
Okay? Like, I need you to do that. That's what I want from you, okay? All right. Thank you. Right. Yes, that's it. That's what I want. Yeah. Do it.
Mocha.
Hi.
Bitch, she about to go in. She brought out the glasses and everything, bitch. Come on.
I'm sorry. I'm going to be the bitch.
Oh.
I'll call you. Be silent.
Okay. Okay, bitch. Yes. Okay. Kiara, my big thing is if you're going to come out here and do drag, I want to see a feminine body. Okay? A lot of your costumes had fitting issues. Was not a big fan. If you're going to do just your normal body, wear pantyhose. However,
great energy.
Does this go out?
Hello.
Okay. Great energy. You had a tuck issue. So make sure when you are wrapping things, make sure it's wrapped. Okay? No peas in the pot.
She said keep the cookies in the jar, bitch. All right, bitch.
Thank you, bud. Great job. All right. Ms. Billy B.
Hi.
When you're modeling, slow down. Like everyone was running a lap around the racetrack. Like, slow down. Like, I want to see your costume. Okay? Execution. Perfect. Your look for your Pop Diva. Great lip sync. Perfect. Your shoe was broken. Sorry, I'm a dancer, so I look at people's feet. So, your shoe was broken. Face. Bitch, if you can clock it. I mean, you can set the eyebrows, but other than that, that's a piece of your cheek. Your body was on point, so thank you.
Yeah.
Stephanie.
Woo!
She brought a fan club.
So there's some aspects about your look. Sometimes I didn't feel like it was creative enough for me. Like, it seemed very mall drag to me. Like you just went out and bought something from the mall and came in and just wore it. Not a good look. I want to see originality. I want to see your look, your personality shine through your outfits. Hey! Shh. Thank you. Once again, when you're modeling, slow down. It's not a race.
It's a drag race, bitch.
But she ain't a horse now. She is not Mr. Ed.
Oh.
Katy Perry loved it. The only thing I did not like was sometimes your lip sync was off. So really, like, draw me into your lip sync. Like, I want to see that you know your words and that you know what the song is talking about. Other than that, energy was great. Keisha.
Come on, give it to me.
Hi, baby. your runway, I looked at the shoes and I was like, Didn't like the shoes with the costume.
For which one? Sorry.
Which
your
one?
Runway.
Which one?
Your first one.
This one.
Yeah. But the fit was great. Perfect. Beyonce, loved it. Work on your lip sync. It seemed like you were fumbling over some of the words when you first started. Other than that, costume malfunction. Like, if you're gonna show them, show them. If you're not gonna show them, show them. Like, I love titties too.
Titties. Titties.
I just gave mine from Victoria's
Secret. The word of the day is titties.
Great concept though. That's really all that I had for you. Emma, hi. Once again, just like everyone else, model. Bitch, you got body. You have, like, I love your body. Like, slow down.
She just made it.
Loved it. Loved it. Your fit was great for your runway. Pop Diva. How's it going out? Oh, thank you. Once again, costume issues and your pop diva. Like, if you don't show me, just show me. Like, if your costume is slipping down, bitch, I would just let it go. I'm like,
just let it go
because that's just only gonna inhibit your performance. And if you let something like that stop you, then every time you have something go wrong with your costume, it's just gonna take away from your performance. Other than that, be more aware of the people who are tipping you. Don't just grab the dollar bill. You need to thank them. You need to show them that you appreciate what they do. Okay?
Thank you.
Oliver. So now that I've seen your look, I understand where you're coming from. And yes, I said body, 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 but even if you are in your natural body, give me some shape. Like, I want to see a corset or something that gives me an hourglass fit. Okay? Right now, you're very boxy. Not a good look for me. Loved your Pop Diva. It, to me, like, everything about that number, the stripping away, like, the costume changes, I was like, oh my God. I wrote originally, I was like, costume change? Confused. But then, I started watching you, and you really surprised me. So, kudos to you.
Yeah.
And honestly, that's all I had.
All right. Oh, it's my turn, so I get to be both nice and mean, apparently. Oh, shit.
I'm gonna start on the other end. Oliver, you really shocked me tonight, I'm not gonna lie.
And your runway for the Big Ten sucked, period, end of day. It just sucked, and that's it. However, your costume change with the hair change, bitch, that last number was everything. You really thought that character through, it was great. You really, really did. Your first runway, you were the most creative out of all of them. You actually did something with the look, so I appreciated that. Oh, Emma. Your costumes are great. What are the colors of the University of Minnesota?
Maroon and gold.
Okay, that's red.
I'm fully aware.
Okay, cool. Just so you know.
Yeah, I know.
That's a cute costume, though. I do like it. I do like it, and your costumes are cute. You really actually are very cute. It's hard to find maroon. I've done it, but it's hard. Just saying. What? That costume Matilda wore earlier belongs to me, so it was maroon and white. Yeah, that's cute. Anyway, that's my read. But, otherwise, your costumes are cute. You know what? When your fucking corset's falling, take it the fuck off and live your life. You know, there are days where your wig is coming off and you just rip that bitch off and move along. I mean, it happened to me in the Disney show, so. Keisha, you play very safe. You know what you're doing. You're an experienced queen. You know what you're doing. You play very safe. Love on Top was a little mumbled, but other than that, I mean, yeah, your titties were hanging out, but bitch, we all have costume fucking malfunctions. I mean, most of you have tonight. It's the evening of titties. So it just goes with it. Stephanie, ball drag is out. Like, we need to do costumes. We need costumes. I need bigger eyes from you as well. That, like she said, they're very closed off. Your performance was actually quite shocking. It was cute. So that's the whole thing. Billy, your runway for the Big Ten That was a great concept. That was a really great concept. Cher really went up. People love Cher. It was great. Kara, your costume for the runway, for the Big Ten runway, that was a cute concept. I didn't get why I went with the University of Illinois, but... Yeah, the Fighting Illini. Oh, okay, cool. Yeah, because as soon as you walked out, I took this bitch just said, finish him. But yes, okay, now that I get it, boo, I got you. Your performance kind of fell short for me. Like, honestly, it was just not there 100%, so. All right, thank you, ladies. You can leave the runway.
Bring back these girls. Welcome back, ladies.
We've had a moment to discuss everything. I'm sure you heard everything. You're 3 feet away. So here's what we're gonna do. Oliver, Emma, and Stephanie step forward. The three of you are safe. But it's safe. You can leave. Thank you. Keisha, I do appreciate everything you put on the stage today. You did have some malfunctions, but at the end of the day, you just didn't bring it the way the other girls did. So tonight you are up for elimination. Billy V, to be honest with you, it's against my better judgment. I think you didn't do as well as some of the other girls, but unfortunately, you know, I was outruled tonight. I mean, they saw something in you that I obviously didn't, so you're the winner of this challenge this evening.
And Billy, the next time you bring an apple, don't nobody eat no Granny Smith. You know, we need a Fuji apple.
It's better be Fuji or I'm throwing it back at
exactly.
you.
Exactly. Thank you.
You what?
That was in my fridge for like 2 months.
Bitch, she's trying to kill me. She's trying to get nothing off of you, bitch. Thank you. You can leave the runway. Kiara, tonight, you fell a little short. You fell short, and I mean, ultimately, the other girls really outshined you, so unfortunately you are in the bottom two as well. So, tonight's lip sync for your life selection is The Eye of the Tiger. DJ, if you can go ahead and play this song for me.
Ooh. Ooh.
brought what you brought. You're an experienced queen, and I know you can do better. Keisha, you're safe. Kiara, I'm sorry, my dear, but you have been eliminated this evening. Thank you. Hi, this is the backstage of Argenta Drag Race Season 3, and this is Kiara von Lorge, who was eliminated tonight, but in a very special segment called Shots Fired. We're going to let Kiara speak her mind. Are you ready, girl?
Yes, ma'am.
Who do you think should have gone home tonight? Wait, what? 1 second. We got to do Shots Fired. Ready? 1, 2, 3. Shots fired!
Well, honestly, the judging sucked. They accused me of my body weight. That means I have to fucking starve myself now. If my body's not right. And the person that should have went home was Emma. One, she didn't do anything with her costumes. She bought them. Two, I had a clear concept of my costumes. Made them myself, hand-stitched them, and sewed them. And I didn't buy them. Three, she needs to perform a little bit more. But other than that, oh well. I go on. That's it.